to bring in now Republican Congressman Adam Kinzinger of Illinois. He serves on the House Foreign Affairs Committee. Congressman, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks.
Chairman Nunes says he was on the White House grounds in order to meet with his source in a secure location where he could view, I guess, the information provided by the source, even though by the Chairman Nunes, I suppose, could have done it on Capitol Hill. What's your reaction to this?
So, I've said from the very beginning we need a bipartisan answer to what happened with regards to Russia and the Trump campaign. I guess I'm having a hard time really seeing what the big, in essence, scandal about the chairman going to the White House itself. I mean, from what I understand, the Intel Committee, the chairman himself, goes to a lot of different areas to view different information. This may be where that was located. And I can tell you, I know Chairman Nunes well. He has a very good reputation in Congress as being fair. I know that he's a patriot, that he intends to do well. So I think the idea of going to the White House to get this information, I'm having a hard time really seeing where that the big scandal is there, because I just don't.
I think the question is, and this is what some Democrats and some critics say, is that if this information, which is seen as favorable to the White House, was provided by the White House, and we know that something was provided now on White House grounds, does that mean that Chairman Nunes, who has oversight over the intelligence community, is instead working for the White House?
No, not necessarily. Again, I think there's really kind of two issues we're conflating here. They're all related to an extent. But there's the area of the issue of people being caught up in unmasking, people being caught up in wiretaps. And the question is then, why were their names released? That is one investigation that I think this is probably more related to. The broader issue of Russia is, I think, being well hounded out in the Senate and the House Intel Committees. So, again, I just don't see the issue of Chairman Nunes going to the executive office of the White House branch, or to the White House ground. It is a huge branch of government, and I don't know that necessarily leads to him saying that, somehow he's working for the president, besides that's just where the information happened to reside that he needed to get a hold of.
Well, if the president's people are giving him information about the president, is it truly an independent investigation?
Well, we don't know. I mean, I don't know who gave him the information, but if it comes from a different counsel, SC, something like that, we just don't know. Again, I just don't necessarily think going there to get the information is a big deal. He admitted, look, hey, if you guys are upset by me going to the White House, I understand that before I brief Congress. But I know him as a person and I know him as a congressman. He is very fair and honest. But look, we have to get to the bottom of what happened. And I think he's doing that. And I think the committee is going to do that, both the Senate and the House side.
All right, Congressman Adam Kinzinger, stick around. We have a lot more to talk about with you, including the president's son-in-law, Jared Kushner, his meeting with the Russian ambassador, a Russian banker, and his imminent meeting with the Senate Intelligence Committee. All right, we're back now with the politics lead. White House officials insist they are not concerned that House Intelligence Chair Devin Nunes met with a source on the White House grounds the night before announcing some of President Trump's personal communications might have been collected during routine surveillance. White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer said, quote, I'm not going to get into who he met with or why he met with them. Back with me now, Republican Congressman Adam Kinzinger of Illinois. Congressman, thanks again for being with us. I want to play for you some sound from Democratic Congressman Jim Himes, who sits on the Intelligence Committee. And this is what he said about the Devin Nunes meeting on White House grounds.
Congress is to serve as a check and a balance on the president, on the White House. And yet Devin and Chairman Nunes has, whatever it is he's done, it has been at the White House. It appears to have been in the service of the White House. And so it is very clear
why,
that he owes us an explanation.
So, Congressman, you've been very clear. You want some bipartisan answers on what went on with Russia. Can you get bipartisan answers from this committee if the Democrats on it don't trust the Republican chair, if the Republican chair isn't giving the Democrats on the committee the information about where he's getting this intelligence? And as far as we know, as of now at 4:13 Eastern time, hasn't shared with him the actual intelligence.
Yeah, I'll leave where to Devin and to the White House to talk about, actually Devin, because he's the one that got it. But look, I think when Congressman Himes, I respect him when he says something like going to the White House, but yet we're supposed to have oversight. Look, that is the executive branch of government. The executive branch of government has some intelligence functions that Congress has to get information from in order to still have oversight and in order to still to do that stuff. So I guess the idea of going to the executive branch does not violate the idea that we're not practicing oversight over the administration. I think you can do both, because, again, the administration is where a lot of this intelligence intelligence is collected and disseminated from. So, you know, look, we need bipartisan answers to this. There's multiple investigations going on in both the House and Senate Intel Committee. The thing I worry about, though, is the more that this is brought into the public sphere, and the media has a responsibility to talk about this, but the more everybody kind of comes out and starts to make this a partisan issue, it actually takes away from the nature of the investigation.
So, Congressman, White House senior advisor Jared Kushner, who happens to be President Trump's son-in-law, he's going to go speak to the Senate Intelligence Committee. He admits meeting with the Russian ambassador during the transition that we already knew about. We learned today, though, that he also met with a Russian banker during the transition, a Russian banker who works for a bank that suffered under sanctions levied by President Obama. Does the idea of these meetings, do they raise any questions for you?
Well, I think he definitely needs to be accountable to it. You know, the idea of meeting with an ambassador, I've met with the Russian ambassador before, and I'm a pretty strong Russia hawk, so that's why ambassadors are here. I don't think it's improper for them to be meeting with an incoming administration. The banking question is something that needs to be answered, especially when you talk about the fact that sanctions were put onto Russia, especially that we had a different president at the time who determined that sanctions were correct, and intensifying sanctions, in fact, because of hackings were correct. We have one president at a time. So it could possibly be improper to have that meeting, and that's the information we need to have. There's probably nothing necessarily illegal about it. There's nothing illegal about meeting with ambassadors, but I think this goes to the whole question that we all need answers to, the American people are asking for answers to, which is what role did Russia play, if any?
What would be improper, possibly, about those meetings?
Well, I think, you know, if you're meeting with a bank, if you're meeting with a bank officer that's been affected by sanctions, you know, the question is, what are you meeting about? And if, in fact, that's a discussion of sanctions or future policy, that could possibly be improper, depending on that was discussed. So I think Jared, Mr. Kushner coming in and speaking to the Senate Intel Committee is probably a good start, and hopefully we get some answers from that.
All right, Congressman Adam Kinzinger of Illinois, thanks so much for being with us.